Hello, good morning students. Hope you all are fine and safe at your home. Once again, I welcome you all in online class. Dear students, we have completed this third lesson almost because only one or two topics are left, okay? And where that is very small. So today we will cover that topic, okay? Some special features of birds. In this lesson, this topic is left and one more topic is left, that is bird's bath. Okay, clear? Some special features of birds, in that we are going to read one point, okay, and I'll explain you. Clear? Before going on this, I would like to say that just you complete your homeworks time to time and learn it, all the things, okay? Whatever homework we are giving to you, please complete it time to time. Once you will do all things, that will be difficult for you, okay? So let's start the topic. Some special features of birds, page number 43 in your general science book. If you are having book, please open that page. First point is, the ostrich is the largest bird and lays the largest egg. This we already know that. Okay, we have already studied that. Yes, the largest bird is ostrich bird and the largest egg is ostrich eggs. Okay, it lays eggs, largest egg, and the size of the egg is about 15 centimeter. 15 centimeter, that means your small scale size, okay? Next topic is, the smallest bird is hummingbird, okay, and the size of the hummingbird's eggs is a size of a pea. Pea means matar ke dane ke barabar, okay. The smallest bird is hummingbird, the smallest egg is of hummingbird, okay, and the largest egg belongs to ostrich, okay. Next point is, owls can turn their heads around and see straight behind them. Yes, students, you know that owl can see in both directions, forward and backward. Okay, we can see only straight, but the owls can see in the forward direction as well as in the backward direction, and it can move their head around. Okay, next, the fourth point is that birds fly long distances in harsh weather to escape unfavorable conditions. This is called migration. Okay, migration is a very important point. Okay, what is migration of birds? That means a group of birds where they are living, if the weather is harsh or weather is not good for them, they are not comfortable in that weather, so they will move from that place, okay, to another place. That is called the migration. Okay, they migrate from one place to another place due to the unfavorable conditions. Okay, that is called the migration. You can see winter season, many different kinds of birds are coming in our state, okay, which is not found here, but in winter season they come from another place in here, okay, in Uttar Pradesh. So that is called the migration. Okay, they migrate long distance, they are flying from one country to country, from one state to another state, okay, like this. So that is called the migration. Okay, next, the bald eagle builds the largest nest. What is the bald eagle? B-A-L-D, it is written there. What is it? Is a type of variety of eagle, a white headed North American eagle. It is mostly found in the North American and it is the national bird of US. Okay, but nowadays it is common in Alaska. Alaska is a place. Okay, so the bald eagle is a white-headed North American eagle that include fish among its prey. Okay, it is the national bird of US. Okay, white-headed means white hair will be there on the head part. Okay, so that is called the bald eagle. Okay, turn your page. Next point is, a baby bird has an eye tooth on its beak that helps to break the egg shell. When they are coming out from the shell, okay, how they come out? With the help of eye tooth, where it is present on the beak. The help of beak only they break the shell and then they come out. Okay, next is the peacock is the national bird of India. Okay, yes, the peacock is the national bird of India. India is our country, so our national bird is peacock. Why? Because it is very beautiful. It has very beautiful feathers, long, beautiful, colorful. Okay, then next topic is next point is parrots can imitate our voice and talk like us. Yes, in many houses some people are keeping the parrot as a pet, a bird, okay, and they train them to speak like a human beings. Okay, they imitate, and parrots having they are having very good quality. They can imitate our voice, they can copy our voice, whatever we are talking. Next is birds communicate with each other. Communicate with each other means they are talking with each other through the calls. Calls means not phone calls, okay? Calls means they call in a different voice, in a different song, in a different way of dancing, or in a different way of feather displays, okay? Then mockingbirds can imitate many sounds. Mockingbirds, the birds which can copy our sounds, okay? They can copy the sounds from a squeaking door to a cat mewing. Okay, squeaking door to a cat mewing means darwaze ki awaaz se lekar ke billi ke bolne ki awaaz tak. Okay, they can copy our voice. Okay, so these are the special features of some special birds. Okay, some other special birds. Clear? Next our topic is bird baths and care for animals. Okay, yes, birds are also taking bath. Are you taking bath every day? Yes, in the summer season or winter season. In winter season you are not taking too much bath every day, but yes, in summer season every day we are taking bath. Okay, because the weather is very hot. Same way for the birds also, this weather is summer season is very difficult for them, because in this weather they are not getting water, enough of water. Okay, so they also feel hot. Okay, so they need to take bath. They fresh their feathers. Okay, they clean their bodies with the help of their beaks, okay, and feet and claws. Clear? Time to time they also care for their body. And we should also care for the animals. This is the main topic and the last topic of this lesson. Okay, so here it is written in your book, placing bird baths and bird feeders is a way to take care of the birds, especially during the summer season. Yes, students, especially this is in this summer season, when you are thirsty, you are going to drink water, that time you just think that okay, we are simply taking and drinking, but birds are not getting any water or any water tank. Okay, so they have to find out. They are flying from one place to another place in search of food and water. So this summer season, as I told you before also, that please put a small pot, in that you can keep the water and keep it on your roof, so the birds can come, okay, and then they can drink, they can take bath, okay, and some grains also you can put, rice, wheat, okay, breads, whatever you are having in your house, that small grains, not too much, small, in a small amount every day you can keep. So like this we can help the birds. Okay, and birds are taking bath, they don't need the swimming pool to take bath. Okay, simply in a small pot also if water will be there, they will sit and they will take bath. Okay, they will cool themselves properly, they will clean themselves, then they will feed. Okay, feeder means the plate in which we keep the bird's grains. Okay, then next is smoke and other air pollutants are hazardous for birds. Hazardous for birds means the smoke, dhuaan, okay, air pollution. Air pollutants are there. Okay, when the air is very polluted, the birds are not able to breathe properly because they have to fly in that polluted air. Okay, so in that time they need difficulties in breathing. Okay, they feel the difficulties in breathing, and then many birds are dying, okay, due to this. And yes, our responsibility is this, to keep our surroundings, environments clean. Nowadays, the students, you can see how many birds we can see because of less pollution. Yes, because nowadays school is closed, offices are closed, okay, all are in lockdown. And due to this is lockdown, the our environment is just, it is coming back, you know. Okay, so they are refreshing now. So nowadays birds are coming in a lot of numbers. Okay, if you want to see, please keep the water and food for the animals, okay, or birds. Clear? The next is kite flying is the sport. Kite flying in the Makar Sankranti time, the people are flying the kites. Okay, boys and girls are playing with the kite. So that sport kills the maximum number of birds. How? Flying of kite, how it kills the birds? Yes, when we fly the kites, in that the thread is there, it is called as manja. Okay, and that is very sharp. Okay, so when we are flying in the high height, so what happened? When the birds are flying and we fly the kites, so with the help of that thread, many birds died. Okay, their feathers, they got hurt, and then after that they died. So that is the problem. So we should take care of this very seriously. Okay, due to our sports, number of birds are dying. So we should stop this. Okay, then we need to take care of them and arrange their convenient living. Okay, so we should provide them with a comfortable and safe place to live. Shed for domestic animals should be made. Okay, and their animals shed should be airy and lighted. Okay, not in a dark place. Clear? These animals should be protected from sunstroke in summer and cold wind in the winter. As we are taking care of our body in the summer, in the winter, season wise we cover our body. Okay, in the winter season, in the summer season we use the airy things. Okay, fan, AC. So like that only we should protect the animals also, because animals cannot do their own works. Okay, they cannot switch on the fans. Okay, so we have to take care of them. Okay, then domestic animals means which we are keeping in our house. They should be kept in clean and their waste should be promptly removed from the shed and be properly disposed of. Promptly means their waste means their waste products, their urines, their dungs. Okay, that should be promptly means immediately they have it should be cleaned. Okay, and removed from their shed, and it should be disposed of at a proper place. We cannot throw it anywhere. Okay, so we have to keep that surroundings clean. Okay, because if the domestic animals will live in a dirty place, the smells will be increased. Okay, and they will get sick. We can get sick. Okay, so here domestic animals should be given nutritive food and or fodder. That means if we are having cow, buffalo, dogs, any other pet animals. So we have to take care of their food items. We should not give the stale food to them. They may also get sick. Okay, so fresh food, fresh fodder we have to give. Okay, then sick animals, bimar animals, okay, they should be treated properly with medicine according to the advice from the veterinary doctor. Veterinary doctor means the doctor who treats the injured animals. Okay, doctor of animals is known as veterinary doctor. So these things are very important. When we are keeping the birds in our house, we have to be careful.